Welcome to video lecture series on subject serving. Today we learn the topic Introduction Components of GIS. Unit number 6, Modern Serving Techniques. So we see the GIS, that is Geographical Information System. In previous lecture, we see the electronic distance measurements. So in that, we have to see the range of the electronic distance measurements. Then GIS. GIS is the nothing but a computer-based tools which is used analyzing, mapping thing that can exist an event that happens over the earth. So without touching any object, you have to take the information regarding these instruments of any things over the earth surface that we have to collect in the form of mapping, and then it is can be analyzed in case of the geographical information system. So GIS technology integrates common database operation such as query and statistical analysis with an unique visualization and geographical analysis benefits offered by the maps. These ability distinguish GIS than any other information system and makes it is visible to wide range of public and private entrepreneurs for explaining events, predicting outcomes and planning strategies. Geographical information system intended to capture, store, manipulate, analyze, manage and present all types of geographical data. It is the simplest term. GIS is merging of cartography, statistical analysis and database technology. So a GIS can be though it is digitally creates and manipulates spatial area that may be purpose of any application related to, and it can be oriented. Generally, a GIS is custom designed for organization. Hence, GIS developed for an application is use of any purpose of over the earth surface. So GIS that can be developed for some other application and any purpose. So it is GIS is an instrument, or it is an techniques. We have to collect the information regarding of any points over the surface without touching that object. Then GIS software is interoperable, supporting the many data formats used in the infrastructure like cycles, and allowing the civil engineer to provide data to various agencies it is required format while maintaining the data for integrity. GIS technology provide a central location to conduct spatial analysis, overlay data and integrate other solution and the system. Built and database rather than individual profit files, GIS enables civil engineers to easily manage, reuse, share and analyze the data, saving time and resources. Other serve as GIS lets you easily data maps, globes and models over the desktop. Serve them a GIS server and use them through a web, desktop and mobile clients. Then components of GIS. So a component of GIS is 5 components such as hardware, software and peoples and the methods. So first we see the hardware. Hardware is the computer on which GIS operates. Today GIS software runs on a wide range of hardware types, from centralized computer server to desktop computers used in standalone or network configuration. Such as then software. GIS software provide the function and tools needed to the store, analyze and display geographical information. Then key software components are tools for the input and manipulations of geographic information, a database management system, tools that support a geographic query, analysis and visualization of geographical user interface such as GUI for easy access tools. Then component of GIS, as we know that hardware, software, data, methods and people. So these are the some components of the GIS. You can see these components. By using these components, we have to collect the information, take the data, interpret it and prepare maps. Okay. Then data. So here possibly the most important components of the GIS is the data. Geographical data are related to the tabular data, can be collected in house or purchased from the commercial data provider. A GIS will be integrate a spatial data with other data resources and can even use a DBMS, then use for the most organization to organize and maintain their data to manage a spatial data. Then GIS technology of limited value, such as a peoples. If you see the another components of the GIS is the peoples. GIS technology is limited value. Without the people who manage the system and develop the plan for applying to its real world problem. GIS user range from technical specialties who design and maintain the system to those who use to help them perform their everyday works. Then methods useful GIS operate according to well-designed plan and business rule, which are models and operating practices unique to each organization. Then how the GIS can be works. A GIS store the information about the words as a collection of thematic layers that can be linked together by geography. This simple but extremely powerful and versatile concept has proven invaluable for solving the many real world problems, from tracking delivery vehicle to recording details of planning application to modeling of globe atmospheric circulations. Then vector and raster data models. It can be converted, the GIS information can be converted, that is the in vector and raster models. Geographical information system works with two fundamentals difference by geographic models such as raster and vector. In vector models, that is the lines, polygons, encoded, and it is in XY coordinates. The location of the points feature such as boreholes can be described by a single in XY coordinates, such as linear features such as roads, rivers can be stored in the collection of the points coordinates. Polygon features such as the cells, rivers, catchments can be stored as a closed loops of coordinates. Then in case of the vector models, it is extremely useful for describing the discrete features, but less useful for describing the continuously varying the features such as the soils types and accessibility cost of hospitals. The raster model has evolved models such as continuous features. A raster image comprises a collection of grid cells rather like a scan map or pictures. Both vector and raster models for storing geographical data have unique advantages and disadvantages. Modern GIS are able to handle both the models. So in this lecture, we see the components parts of GIS and users such as peoples, data, models and methods of vector and raster models. Okay, thank you for the watching this video. Thank you.